looks like Matthew, chapter 28. I'm going to read again verses 18 through 20. Amen. I'm glad that this is a meditation. Amen. Chapter 28. Amen. At verse 18, very familiar passage. And Jesus came and spoke to them, saying, "All authority has been given to me in heaven and on earth. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all things that I have commanded you, and lo, I'm with you always, even to the end of the age." Amen. I want to take about 10 minutes and talk to you from the subject, how to reach the masses. How to reach the masses. There are two kinds of texts that are most difficult to preach from. There are those texts that are so unfamiliar to the average person in the congregation until you have to spend much of your time explaining the storyline and establishing the context of the text.
That's right. Mm-hmm.
The other text that is most difficult to preach from is the text that's so familiar.
Right.
For as soon as you announce a familiar text, the person in the congregation already come to the conclusion that they know what is about to be said. The Great Commission is a very familiar text. We've heard it all of our lives. This mission mandate has been at the center of all of the great gatherings of the church fathers since the founding of Christianity. Here in this Great Commission, Jesus gives us our marching order. He has completed his mission, and now he leaves the work he started in the hand of those who would follow him.
Yeah.
Every great theologian, every bishop, every preacher, every mission, every person who ever claimed Jesus as Lord of their lives must accept this challenge and obey this command to go into all the world and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all things. And he says, "Lo, I'll be with you always, even to the end of the age." Whatever else we do as the Church of God, as followers of Christ, this commission must be at the center of our focus. How do we win the world for Christ? How do we evangelize the world that we might reap a great harvest in our day? When we look at our day, the day in which we live, some would say instead of us reaching the masses, we're losing the masses. How do we turn this thing around? Surely Jesus wouldn't command us to do something if it was impossible for us to do it. Those who came before us have preached and taught and from this text throughout the years. They were looking for directions and instructions as to how to be successful in fulfilling this great commission. Jesus is speaking to his disciples. We understand the disciples to be those who would follow him back then and those who would follow him even today. He's telling his disciples to go, which means to take action, to busy ourselves by making disciples, by baptizing and teaching the gospel of Jesus Christ. The word go means do it now. Don't waste any time. And the place to go is into all the world and to preach to all nations. The who, the what, the when, the why of this text is clear. We understand what Jesus is saying. But he did not tell us how. The how is just out of the text. You can't find it in another gospel, nor is it in this one. How are we going to make disciples? How can we be successful in this mission management? Should we employ? Now, you can argue that the gospel writers was careless and they left something out. Or you can say in the translation process, when the Bible was being translated from one language to another language, something got left out. I believe that Jesus intentionally left the how. Because he knew that the times would change. And what worked for those disciples on that hillside in Galilee will not work for us today. Things are changing all the time. Nothing remains the same. We were the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. He left the how. So I believe that we might be receptive to change. He left the how, I believe, because he knew that we need to be led by the Spirit of God. For as many that are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons and daughters of God. I believe that's why he made that last statement. The last statement in the text, he says, "Lo, I'll be with you always." For he's there with us in the process to lead, guide, and direct us and to instruct us when our wills are aligned with his will. Go ahead and teach all nations. Now, the missionary says we're working with personal responsibilities. And I want you to know that this commission begins with personal preparation. Let me say it again so you can get it. Personal preparation. I got to make sure that I am the disciple he's calling me to be. I got to learn how, if I'm going to make disciples, I got to first be what he wants me to be. I got to learn how to walk by faith with him. I got to learn to trust him. I got to learn how not to lean on my own understanding. I got to learn the secret of sacrifice. I got to learn how to give up my way for his way. Take up my cross and follow him. I got to develop a personal relationship with him. I got to learn how to be a part, give it now, a part of the family of God. You see, we're all in this thing together. No big guy, no little you. I got to learn how to deal with my neighbor. None of you two folks like that want to be treated. After we develop a personal relationship with him, if we are able to tell others about him, when we love him with all our heart, with all our mind, all our soul, and all our strength, then we are able to testify about what God can do. Our testimony, what he means to us, what he's done for us. When we tell somebody else how he lifted up. If he really been lifted. If we tell somebody how he lifted us from the shades of night into that marvelous light. After we've had that personal relationship with him, then we are ready to lift him up. And when we lift him up, the Bible says he'll draw all men unto himself. Yes. So how to reach the masses?
Yes.
Men of every birth.
Yes.
For an answer, Jesus gave you peace.
Yes.
If I be lifted up,
come on.
I'll draw all men unto me. Without testimony.
Yes.
We let the world know that Jesus is the best thing that ever happened to us. When we lift him up by walking in obedience to his command. When we love each other and forgive each other like he forgave us, we are lifting him up. And if he be lifted up, he'll draw all men. Yes, if we lift him up with our lifestyle.
Yes.
With our Christian character and our conduct,
yes.
He will draw our sons and daughters
yes.
back to the house of God.
Yes.
Huh? Yeah, when we lift him up, he'll heal broken relationships.
Yes.
When we lift him up, he'll be there with us in the process of making disciples.
Yes.
For he said, "Lo, I'll be with you always. Even until the end of the world."
Yeah.
We gotta get ourselves right first.
Yeah.
And then all we need to do is lift up Jesus.
Yeah.
If we lift him up,
yeah.
he'll throw the addict from his addiction.
Yeah.
If we lift him up,
yeah.
he'll throw the prostitute from the street corner.
Yeah.
If we lift him up,
yeah.
he'll bless our church. Yes,
yeah.
he will. For he promised never to leave us. He goes with us on our mission. He walks with us as we walk with him. Yes, isn't it wonderful to know that we don't go on this mission by ourselves? That we have a friend that can get closer than a brother. And his name is Jesus. Mary's baby. Jesus, the Rose of Sharon. Jesus. The little and the daddy, Jesus, the bright and morning star. He goes with us in the process. He's there with us to encourage us. He's there with us to help us. He's there with us to strengthen us. He's there with us to bring us out more than conquerors. Yeah, we don't go alone. This is not our ministry alone. Jesus is now with us. He's the very presence of him at all times. He'll lead us by his spirit. He'll direct us in what to say. He'll show us the way. I'm going to my seat. But I want you to know there's nobody like Jesus. Amen. There's nobody like Jesus. He alone is worthy of all honor. He's worthy of every song that ever been sung to him. He's worthy of every verse that ever been written of him. He's worthy of every dollar that ever been given to him. He's worthy of every soul that ever surrendered unto him. I'm going to sit down. Only one. The blessed Jesus. He is the one when afflictions press the soul and the waves of trouble roll. And you need a friend to help you. Jesus is the one.